Hello everybody, Van Zan here again with a quick video showing the features of my newly acquired active PA set by Skytech. They're called the QTX Professional 15-inch PA by Skytech, rated at 400 watts RMS or 800 the pair. Officially they're also rated at PMPO peak at 1.5k between the two, but this is a pointless reading ultimately because if you go anywhere near peak they explode all over the dance floor, so a little bit beside the point. Right, they have 100 watt titanium horn mounted tweeters with 300 watt mid to low end 15 inch drivers. They are completely independent of each other. They're both by amps. They have 2 amps inside each, as I say, 100 and 300 respectively. And they were £340 or thereabouts for the pair from hifitower.co.uk. I've never had any dealings with these guys in the past, but I ordered them last Friday and they turned up on Monday. I could not be happier, to be entirely fair. I was a little put off by the idea of buying Skytech because they are budget, as I say, and a few people online have been less than kind about their sort of reviews. But it has to be noted that this QTX Pro is what they describe as the professional end of their kit. And I've been around PA for a great majority of my life, of different ranges, prices, sizes, outputs, so on and so forth. And I have to say, in direct proportion to the money, these are some of the best speakers I've ever heard. Anyway, let's go in closer and have a look at some of the features. Okay, let's go around the back section of the unit and see what we've got. Well, on the left-hand side, you've got your microphone subsection, switchable line input between mic and auxiliary line, jack plug, microphone output level, and reverb, echo, not something I'd ever dream of doing, but hey, there you go, each to their own. On the playback side, over here, we've got your standard treble and bass controls, and overall volume, overall gain. Just as a side note, it has to be said at this point, considering these are basically budget PA, I mean, they're marked as pro, but I mean, God, that goes up and up, professional level. As I say, these are considered budget, but the build quality of these pots is nothing short of exemplary. They're smooth, there's no play in them, they feel like they're on a really nice linear track, they're lovely. Anyway, down here, we have phono left and right, or RCA, as I think it's Americans call it, in from your mixing, your mixer, mixing kit or whatever. And likewise, you have stereo RCA phono out, right and left out, for connecting to an auxiliary bass bin, or as far as I know, the other speaker to slave them up. As a footnote, it should also be noted that these speakers can be run single RCA in one right, single RCA in the other left. Also, over here on the right, you have something called a speak-on connector. Not something I use, but it's very useful to have it nevertheless. Even though these are active speakers, if you go to a gig and somebody has a more capable amp than the amps inside here, I'm not saying they're not good, but you know, an external amp should generally always be better, then you connect it via this and it locks, which is good. It means it can't just fall out the back. Another nice little feature of these PA speakers is the fact that they've got these little veins at the side. I mean, you sort of see that? These little sort of veiny things. And what they basically do, it's an inbuilt stand that allows you to have the speaker side-mounted or laterally mounted, I think they call it, for monitoring or for situations where you're just not called on having your speakers in vertical aspect. They also have fairly firm, well-built carry handles. Unfortunately, they don't have one on the top or the other side, so I guess the idea is that you pick it up and kind of balance it like a suitcase. They're getting on for about 20 kilos, about 18, 19 kilos, two and a bit stone in English terms, in English weight. So they're not too bad in terms of weight. They are extremely solidly built though. Rugged would be the word. They really are heavy. On the other side, we have these things called top hat mountings. And basically what they do is, if you don't have speaker stands and you put them down on a flat surface on the floor, if you notice they lift the speakers off the floor, you know, to the tune of maybe, I don't know, inch and a bit. And also, if you mount them on top of another speaker, it gives you a little bit of separation so that you don't suffer from reverb or back echo or anything like that. Sort of bass washout, whatever you want to call it. And, cats love them. Don't know why. Couldn't tell you why. As soon as I turned them on, this one was up on top of it, purring and fell asleep and all sorts. Yeah, see what I mean? Anyway, back to the video in hand. Under here, we have the standard 26mm pole port, whatever you'd call it, for mounting on stands. with the fixing screw, don't know what you call it, doodad. There you go, it's a doodad. So it's got the doodads, can't go wrong really. Right, well, enough babble. Let's plug them all in and see what they sound like. So, until next time, this is Van Zan, signing out.